Hello everybody, SlimKirby here, and welcome to my new Let's Play. Hello everybody, SlimKirby here, and welcome to Let's Play Dixie Kong's Double Trouble, Donkey Kong Country 3. This is the third game of the Donkey Kong Country series on the Super NES. In terms of how I rank the games, I'd probably put this as second best, mainly because I love Donkey Kong Country 2 so much, and this game does borrow a lot of stuff from Donkey Kong Country 2. I really don't know what to say about what makes it lower than Donkey Kong Country 2, though. I don't know, that's just my own personal opinion. I honestly had a lot more time with Donkey Kong Country 2 and played it a lot more, but this game also has kind of its unique charm as well, and I do also really like it. In fact, there's not a single game of the DKC franchise that I don't like, so, I mean, that's just my own personal opinion. Anyway, we're gonna start our file here. Obviously gonna be a one-player game, and we don't have very many spaces for lettering, so I think I'm probably just going to put Slim in here. I think that'll probably fit if I go the right way when going through the letters. Okay, yeah, we got this. So, the basic plot of this game is that Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong have been captured, and it's up to Dixie Kong, the sidekick of Donkey Kong Country 2, to save them both. And she's also going to get a little bit of help along the way from another Kong that we'll be meeting shortly. Anyway, here's Wrinkly, the Save Master from DKC2. She's going to reprise her role as the Save Master in this game. So if we need to save our game, we'll come here and we'll just save our game. That's basically all we have to do. So yeah, as you can see, we can see all the collectibles we can get in the game. The silver coins you see at the bottom left, those are actually unimportant. You need to collect them as you go throughout the game, but they don't actually, they're not actually required for 100% necessarily, so we can collect them at our own leisure. Those coins with the B on them, those are bonus coins. The coins with the DK on them are the DK coins. We also have banana birds. We'll be seeing all of these later. And when we collect everything in the game, we'll have a score of 103% on our file select screen. That's right, not 100%, 103%. That is kind of cool how the Donkey Kong Country games kind of added a percent for each game, because I believe in DKC2 it was 102%. Anyway, we have two other places we can go to. We have Bazaar's General Store, we'll stop here later. And we also have Funky's Rentals. Funky actually plays a pretty big role in this game. He gives us our means for transporting around the map. Yo, Dixie, what's happening? And he also has our nephew, our cousin Kiddy Kong, who is going to be the sidekick for this game. You could almost compare Kitty to a slightly weaker version of Donkey Kong in the original Donkey Kong Country. But anyway, the only boat of transport we have right now is the motorboat. With the motorboat, we can't do very much. We can't go over rocks, so we're kind of stuck to this little area over here. But as we go throughout the game, we'll get more parts that we can use to actually build more vehicles. So we'll be doing that as we go throughout the game. Right here, we have a sandy beach. It looks like it's nothing, but if you actually press the A button while you're on here, you actually find a secret, and this is Bounty Beach. As you go throughout the game, you'll find these little secret caves, and you have to play a small little Simon Says game. Each of the crystals corresponds to the buttons on the Super NES controller. But yeah, just follow the pattern, and you will get a banana bird. I don't remember how many banana birds there are in the game, but we will have to collect all of them if we want to get the best ending, so to speak, and get 103%. So we'll be on the lookout for those. But over here we have our first world, which is Lake Orangatanga, and the first level, which is Lakeside Limbo. Now, the controls of this game, if you've played any Donkey Kong Country game, they should be very familiar. You can run around, you can jump, you can pick up your Kong buddy and throw him or her. You can also switch between Kongs with the select button. And both Kongs actually have their unique moves. If you remember for Donkey Kong Country 2, Dixie has her famous helicopter spin, which allows her to softly glide for a few moments until she lands on the ground. Kiddy does not have anything like that. He has a unique ability, but we'll see that a little later, and it's actually not very useful either. But anyway, this is Donkey Kong Country, so go to places up here to find secrets. You can find 2 extra lives right off the bat. And as usual, collect 100 bananas to get a 1-up, collect all 4 Kong letters to get a 1-up, and just be on the lookout for other collectibles as well. And there's a bonus barrel right here. We can't get there, but if we switch to Dixie Kong and throw Kiddy and his heavy butt, we can actually break through that and get to the bonus barrel. You beat a bonus game and you get a bonus coin. I believe there are 75 throughout the game, so there's quite a few of them. And there's also approximately 2 bonus levels in every single level, with exception to the Lost World and also the boss levels, so don't look for them there. And here's the other collectible. We'll find one of these guys in every level. This is Coin. Coin has a giant shield with a decoy coin in it. But in order to get that coin, we have to throw a metallic barrel and hit him in the back with it. And then we get the coin. And every level has their own unique little coin trap that you have to figure out how to get the coin. It's pretty cool. I like how they kind of did that with this game. Did something a little unique, I guess. Also, you can find these silver coins. They're bear coins, like I mentioned earlier. If you want a kind of an explanation of what they do, think of the banana coins from the last game. They kind of perform that same function. You can go to around the map and buy certain services. They're mostly going to be used, though, for getting 100% because there's a lot of stuff we can collect. Anyway, here's our second bonus barrel. And this is a unique game that was added to the bonus games for this game. Grab 15 bananas. Green bananas will appear on the stage and you have to grab them before they disappear, and you have to collect 15 to win the bonus coin. Some of these can be pretty tricky depending on the layout and what you're supposed to do to get the bananas. Of course, this one's not that bad because they're just all in plain sight, but they'll add enemies, and they'll add other traps as we go along, so they're not all going to be that easy, obviously. But for the most part, whenever we play the bonus games, you're going to see a lot of those examples where you have a star game, and you also have a green banana game, and they basically take place in the same kind of layout. Anyway, new animal buddy. This is Ellie the elephant. Ellie can actually pull barrels towards her, and then throw them at enemies. She's pretty cool. She also has kind of a water-spitting move as well, but we won't see that yet. That's mostly going to be done later. And yeah, that was just kind of a small little preview of what Ellie can do. Nothing really that extensive. You can also find some secret stuff over here. Do that before you grab the rope over there to end the level. And then grab the rope. Now, if you collected everything in the level, on the world map, you'll see 2 flags. You'll see a blue or pink flag. Those flags signify what Kong actually pulled it. But if the flag is actually waving, you got all the bonus areas. And if you see that little yellow flag, you also grab the DK coin. So we can fully completed that level, and we can move on to the next one. And that's pretty much all of the explanatory stuff I really have to do for this. I can kind of stop doing that now, because I think you guys probably understand. A lot of people know the Donkey Kong Country games, but, you know, there's a select few out there who have never played them before, so just trying to cater to those people who might not know everything there is to know about this game. Now, one of the things I really like about Donkey Kong Country 3 is that each level has its own unique gimmick, so to speak. I don't like using the word gimmick normally, just because gimmick can also be kind of a negative connotation. But I don't know, like, every level kind of has their own little unique trait. And I guess Donkey Kong Country 2 also did that, but I feel like there were a lot more, like, standard levels in that game. But, like, for example, the gimmick for this level is the door that you have to open with those little levers at the top. So That's kind of the gimmick for this level. And each level will essentially have its own unique gimmick. The only one that really doesn't is probably the first level. That level is just kind of an introductory level that doesn't really have to do anything. But still, though, a lot of the gimmicks are very clever. I really like them, and I think that the overall Rare just did a great job with making those for this game. A lot of people disagree, though. A lot of people kind of consider this the black sheep of the DKC franchise. I don't agree. Like, I mean, it is different in its own unique way, but I think that's what makes the game great, in all honesty. I mean, Donkey Kong Country 2, let's face it, that's probably everybody's favorite game. But, I mean, this game is essentially just like it, for the most part. I mean, you really can't disagree with that statement. I mean, it's pretty similar. Especially because you have Dixie, and let's face it, everyone loved Dixie in Donkey Kong Country 2 because she could fly over everything. So, I don't know, that's just... A lot of people consider this a black sheep, and I just don't agree. I really like it. Again, Donkey Kong Country 2 will always be my favorite. That's the way it's been. That's probably the way it's always going to be, but still, I really love this game too. In fact, I had a phase where I actually played this game a lot more than the sequel, and like me and my friend would try to see how fast we could beat the game and get on that high score leaderboard at the end of the game. We both just had a really fun time with that. Okay, let's get up here. So yeah, I expect a lot of the levels to be pretty formulaic with the whole gimmick system I talked about earlier. Okay, coming up here we'll have the end of the level. And you need to be careful because this is easily missed. But if you actually hug the left wall, you'll find the area where Coin is. And as you can see, we can't really throw the barrel behind him normally. We have this door, though, so let's quickly grab this, and then just chuck the barrel through the door, and voila! Pinball saves our lives. Good old pinball. Okay, let's fall straight down here to actually grab a 2-up, and then we finish the level. Alright. I think for the most part, I'm going to follow the same trend I always try to go for with my videos. I'm going to try to make them in between 15 and 20 minutes. I'll go over 20 minutes sometimes if like I'm in the middle of a level when we get to that point. But for the most part though, I'm going to try to make them in between 15 and 20. So yeah, we can save our game. Let's go ahead and do that. And hooray, we're 5% through the game. Wow, that's a lot more progress than I figured we'd be at this point. But that's cool. Like I said before, this game is actually not very long, so I don't expect very many videos for this project. None of my DKC projects have ever gone over the 15 video mark, so I kind of expect that this project to do the same thing. Anyway, over here, yeah, we have another secret cave, Smuggler's Cove. Let's see what we can do for this. A lot of these are pretty easy, especially because it's random, so sometimes you might get a pattern where it's just the same one every single time. Very unlikely that'll happen, but it is possible, that's for sure. Anyway, let's pay a visit to this island in the middle. We can't really do anything with it right now. But basically, all across this land, you'll find these bear shacks, and this is where you'll normally use the bear coins. But anyway, you'll find like a bear in pretty much every world, and you'll also find a few of them on the main world map as well. And a lot of them have ways to get birds, so you're going to want to stop in with all of them and kind of listen to their story and see what they can do to help you. So let's go to Barnacles Island.
Hello there, how's it going, Kongs? Barnacles my name, and I've set up home here to build a new shell collection, and...
Yeah, they kind of speak too fast for my own good, so I'll just let you guys read. So yeah, we can't do anything to get that banana bird yet, but we could actually do it right now, but I'll probably wait on that until I have access to the world map again. But yeah, I'm probably going to do this video, or do this level, and then probably end the video there. So let's do this one. Okay, so once again, we have coin right off the bat. So let's grab the barrel that's up here. And let's just hit him in the back again. Hooray! Also, whenever you throw your fellow Kong, whenever you throw with Kiddy Kong, you kind of have an underhanded throw with Dixie. You have a little more height with this kind of throw. And with Dixie, well, first of all, you can't really throw Kiddy Kong very far, but whenever you throw barrels and stuff like that, Dixie has kind of an overhand throw. You'll find that different throws are more advantageous for certain situations, so just keep that in mind. Also, I guess it's time to show off Kitty's unique ability. We know Dixie has her helicopter spin, but what does Kitty have to offer? Well, Kitty actually has a water skip ability, where if you roll into the water and jump when you touch the surface of it, you'll actually get a little bounce. So let's go ahead and try that. I failed. Let's try again. Now, you won't actually have to use that very much. We'll have to use it in this level to get a bonus area, but aside from that, you really don't use it much. You only use it, like, in two levels, and in other levels if you want to, like, speedrun them or something. So, yeah, you're not going to really use that ability very much at all. Also, N'Guard. N'Guard is back. I believe, technically, he's the only animal buddy that appears in all three games. Squawks also does, but his ability was different in Donkey Kong Country 1, so I don't like to count him because of that. But yeah, Squawks is technically here too. But N'Guard is the only familiar face. Well, no, not the only familiar face, but the only buddy that has technically appeared in all three games. We will see a familiar face from Donkey Kong Country 2. But that is for another day, and much later in the game. Okay, so let us continue. That bonus I mentioned earlier is actually really annoying to get. And yeah, you're going to want to have to use Dixie to get this. I'll go ahead and try it, just because there is a DK barrel right here. Hooray! Watch out for the buzz saws. I know, they're not zingers anymore. They're actually called buzz saws in this game. Which is kind of weird, but that's what they're called. Okay, right here. This is where you actually access the bonus area I was talking about earlier. If you don't screw up like I did. Okay, so here's where you get the bonus. And as you can see, the bananas are indicating that we need to use a water skip for this. You can actually use Dixie for this as well, but you have to jump at the exact right time. So they kind of encourage you to use Kiddy Kong for this, which is really difficult. Let's see if I can do this. Ah, dang it. Just too early. So yeah, and there's actually no way we can get the bonus now because we destroyed those ladybug slash flutter enemies. So we'll have to do this level again, but that's okay. I don't have a problem with that. I'll just attach that to the end of this video. But yeah, like I said, you can also use Dixie for that too, but it's you have to be very precise. And oh dang it, I missed some bear coins if I would have smashed through that floor. But anyway, this has been SlimKirby. This has been Let's Play Donkey Kong Country 3, Dixie's Double Trouble. I will see you guys in a second for this bonus area, and then I'll see you again for the next video. So hope you guys enjoyed. See you guys next time. Later, folks.